Good morning, and welcome back to Terra Firma Punk, a mod pack that I've been working on. And while I have been having some people beta test for me, several of them have been asking some really basic Terra Firma craft questions, like how do I survive my first night? So I'm going to go ahead and make a tutorial. I might even make a series out of this, on how to get through some of the basic Terra Firma craft basics. So that's what this is going to be about, some basics. Now this is a seed that I've found during some of my testing and developing. It seems to be a fairly good seed, definitely a rock. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start out by picking up all these sticks. I'm going to leave these rocks here for now. I'll get into explaining them at some point later. Now, if you haven't noticed over here, there was a brown bear. He's fairly dangerous, so we want to avoid him as much as possible. And there are some berry bushes here, and they do not appear to be fruiting at this point, so I'm going to leave them alone. Ooh, here is some crops. We want to pick up those. That's going to serve us as some food for right now. That's one of the first things you want to start doing is looking for food while you're picking up rocks and sticks. Rocks and sticks are going to be the very first thing you want to pick up here. Just pick up a bunch of these rocks and, oops, I didn't mean to pick that up, but I'll hold on to it for now. I do also want to start punching these trees. They will only give saplings if you punch the leaves, so you have to do that. But they will also give you sticks, so I'm going to need quite a few sticks. Now, this is one of the better seeds that I've seen because it doesn't have a lot of dry grass. You're surrounded by trees, you've got a nice little cove, you're next to the ocean, you have these berry bushes here, you have some decent ore on the ground, and you're right next to a small pool of fresh water. Oh, and look, I'm already finding some more crops. There we go. So, I believe that covers pretty much all of my basics. Now, to stack these all together, I just hit the letter S on my keypad and it went ahead and stacked everything together. And there's also wildlife around. Jeez, that took off fast. And there's a big patch of clay right here. Clay is going to be very important to getting started and getting on to more advanced phases of the game, and it's also one of the key survival techniques that I'm going to show you guys, probably the first one. Hey, look, there's pheasants. They're going to provide a decent amount of meat. So, all right, I've got more than enough rocks. I've got a lot of rocks. So the next thing I want to do is I want to get some tools going, and I definitely want to get wood, so I want to make an axe. And to do that, I hold two rocks in my hand and I hit right click to open up this interface. And I'm going to go ahead and nap the two rocks together, basically cracking together, breaking off, chipping off pieces. And each one of these squares represents one of the pieces I'm going to chip out of the rock. And there we go, we have a stone axe. Let's go ahead and make ourselves a weapon. I'm going to make a javelin. Now, I also want to make some knives to start with. And skeletons are not affected by, or not, they're resistant to slashing weapons. So you want to make a better weapon for skeletons. You want to make something that does what's called crushing damage. And I'm going to do that right now. I'm going to make a hammer. And that looks like that. So that I'm going to use against skeletons. Now that I've got these stone tool heads, let's go ahead and make a bunch of tools. So I'm going to start with my axe. Put that out of the way, that out of the way. I'm going to make the stone hammer. We'll set that aside. Let's make the stone javelin. And let's go ahead and make two knives. We're going to need the knives for quite a few other things as well. So one of the things the knife can do is you attack the grass, you slash the grass, and you get what's called thatch. Now, if you're familiar with earlier versions of Terra Firma Craft, you used to be able to stand on thatch and use it as a building block or even a defensive tool for building a little tower up in the air so that enemies could not get to you. But that is no longer the case. So you take this thatch and, oh, I'm going to need one more. Give me that. Okay. So this will get us, should get us, come on. It's not splitting correctly. There we go. Should get us 10 pieces of thatch. Now we're not going to be able to build with that. So let's talk next about how to deal with thirst. I'm going to hit the S key to stack those. Now, thirst is a little different in this one. Earlier versions, you used to be able to just stand in the water, but you can no longer do that. Now you have to point your cursor at the water and hold down the right mouse button, and that'll start drinking water. Until we actually have clay pots, that's going to be the way to start out. Now, as you can see, my hunger is going down, so I want to fill that up with my garlic. So, let's talk about the different survival techniques for getting through your first night. It's still fairly early in the day, but I want to cover as many of these as I can. Good, there's a rock over there. We're going to need it in a second. Now, if you look at this ground here, it's covered in these goldenrod flowers. Now that tells you that there is clay underneath. It may actually be as much as two blocks down. There may be a layer of dirt on top of it and then clay below. So what you're going to need to get to the clay is a shovel. And that's one of the tools that I forgot to make. So let me grab my. Actually, let's finish off this knife while we're at it. There we go. Knife is gone. So let me grab my sticks, and we're going to need to want a shovel to collect the clay. And the shovel looks like this. And in fact, I believe I'm going to want a couple of shovels. There's two. We stick those shovel heads up there, and we shall be on our way. Now, I've got a pine sapling, so I'm going to go ahead and plant that over here in this grass so it'll grow up eventually. Now, to survive your first night, you're going to want to avoid all the monsters and find some place to hide out. You used to be able to dig into a cliffside, so let me go ahead and demonstrate what happens to that. Digging into a cliffside used to be one of my favorite things to do. And okay, that's rock. Well, I guess so I can do it right here. This will be fine. I used to be able to hide myself in a little dirt. Whoa, or rock. But as you can see, if you dig the dirt, it falls. In the previous version, the grass used to hold up the dirt, but it no longer does. So this doesn't really make a viable shelter. But I saw Woolly Creeper do this first technique with the clay, so I wanted to show you guys how to do this first. Let's dig in here. Yeah, there we go. There's. Okay, let's take a step back. So, what you'll notice about the clay is that it doesn't fall down. This first technique I simply call the under the hill technique. It's probably one of the easiest ways, and Okay, so as I was saying, I believe this is one of the safest and most practical ways to get yourself set up for your first night. The other ways either leave you a little too exposed or have a tendency to burn down when you start working. Like, when you start working with pottery and getting a fire going, if you do it inside of a wooden shelter, you can end up burning your house down. So, it's not the best way to hide inside or build a shelter to hide in. I think coming in underground, it's not the prettiest, definitely not the prettiest. But you can at least get yourself set up with, like, a pit kiln and a fireplace. Now, one of the things I forgot to do while it was daylight was get some wood. So I'm going to take a chance and come out here with my axe, and I'm going to chop down this tree. And it takes a long time to chop down. Okay, so I'm going to need some of that wood. And while I'm down here, I'm going to want to block this. Actually, you know what? I'm going to need another stack of wood. Keep an ear out for monsters like zombies and stuff. Alright, that was a better stash of wood. So, let's go ahead and block up the entrance while we're at it. Okay, we got pine and Douglas fir. Oh, that's why. Alright, I'm going to block that off with pine. It's probably really dark for you guys. You know, settings, brightness all the way up. Alright, so what I'm going to do next is get some light going, and that'll take me a second. I need a fire starter. I need to not listen to the creepy noises. Next thing I need to do is take 3 sticks, throw them on the ground, and light them with the lighter. Alright, now that we have some light, you guys can see what's going on. Alright, so I'm going to put some pine logs in there for now to get it lit up, or keep it going. And now I've got some torches, so we're going to torch up the place a little bit, just to keep the light going. And we're going to cook this garlic just a little bit. We're going to roast it. You guys like roasted garlic? Well, I'm going to roast the garlic, and I'll be back in a second. Okay, you'll notice that the garlic has 3 different bars on it. The top bar is its temperature gauge. The top red bar. The green bar is its quality, I believe. I noticed that when the food starts to decay, the green bar will start going down. And the higher percentage of decay, the farther the green bar goes down. And the final bar is its ounceage. How many ounces out of 160, which is 2 pounds, I believe. I believe that's right. Or 10 pounds, 20 pounds, 8 ounces to a pound, excuse me. American standard measurements. So this has 91 ounces, roughly 11 pounds, 12 pounds, I believe. That's a lot of garlic. So with that much garlic, it will actually last us quite a while. So I'm going to fill up on the garlic. And one of the other things I mentioned was a pit kiln. Let me make a jug. Actually, I want to make a couple of jugs. So I'm doing the same thing I was with just basic napping, and I'm using clay balls to do that with. That's why the digging into a clay hillside is a good idea, because you also get clay out of it. And the second reason I was going to show you guys here in a second why this makes such a good little home is because I can stick a pit kiln in it and have the pit kiln inside of the house. I don't have to leave it outside. In fact, if I was being attacked by a zombie horde, I could still come in here and build my fire and cook my food and also have my pit kiln in here. So with the pit kiln, I want to fill that up with 8 pieces of straw and 8 more pieces of wood. Now I'm going to take my last torch and I'm going to throw it onto the pit here, and that will light my pit kiln. I could also use my fire starter if I choose to, but I like the torch idea because it's only half a stick, which isn't too bad. So there, I still have some more torches. Anything else I want to cook? Let's bring that up to medium. And you notice the color actually changes too. So I'm gonna wait for the pit kiln to finish, and we'll be right back. Okay, a skeleton has entered my home, and I need to dispatch him before he kills me. Ow! He's kicking my butt. Woohoo! So the hammer didn't completely finish the guy off, but that was pretty rough. Oh no! Oh no! There's another one. Run away! Okay. Yeah, he's stuck in the water. Thinking that was the one that was in my house. Yeah, he came out and got burned. Look at all those arrows. So I have a bone. All right, and I'm full of arrows. So the pit kiln isn't finished cooking. So I was just opening the door to come take a look around, and got attacked. I thought I could bring him down with the hammer, but it looks like it took more than one hammer to kill him entirely. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show the next technique. Hopefully I have enough lumber for it. I've even got some dirt, so we can go ahead and use that. Now, the next technique is to simply build a little shelter against a tree like this. Now, this is going to take a little more time and planning than it would be, say, just dig a hole in the clay. That's a lot faster and easier to get done. But this works fairly well. And I may need another axe. So if you've got a lot of extra time on your hands during the first day, you can also go ahead and just make a wooden shelter, put it up against a tree, put it between a couple of trees. That works just as well. So let me finish chopping this down. But I spent a lot of time talking in the first night, so I really didn't have a lot prepared or a lot of time to prepare for this type of a house. Now for this, let's put some torches in the house and then a couple of them outside. It tends to look a lot neater, definitely a not lot neater. And what you can do for a door, you could, if I were to use thatch for a door, Monsters can still see through it, and I can still walk through it. And they can actually come in and attack you through your thatch. You could put it up in the roof, but spiders tend to climb up and get through it. So what my friend Woolly Creeper recommends is to use these particular things for a doorway. Actually, let's switch. I don't have enough to fill the door entirely, so let's put down a piece of dirt and we'll put a log in there. So that's a temporary door. It's fairly easy to remove, just like that, and then you can break your dirt and it's really easy to put back. But until you're able to get metal tools and actually make a full door, these actually make fairly decent doors. Now the reason I can't use one on the lower one is because if I have one on the ground, I can't place another one on top of it. What it's doing is it's sticking that other piece of log inside of it. So it's doing that. And I won't be able to put another log on top or another log stack on top until this one has 16 logs in it. So what I'm going to do is show you guys the last and final survival technique. This one is what I like to call high and dry. And this one usually happens to work in fairly dire straits. Now let me see if I can find one that's pretty good. That one looks all right, but it's got a lot of exposed surface. And we have some more food. We got some rice. That's gonna be nice. Now the high and dry technique requires a boulder. Boulders are all over the place, easy to spot out in the plains. And if you run across, say, skeletons who like to shoot at you, the plains are a good place to hide from skeletons. The high and dry method isn't too bad against skeletons and spiders as well. But what it does give you is the ability to defend yourself in a what I call a pinch. Like, you're in trouble, you've got a whole bunch of zombies coming at you from all directions. You quickly need a place to, you know, climb up and just spend the night. So there is the high and dry method. I need to get some more wood. So let me chop down this tree. And I'll demonstrate. There's a couple of extra features that some of the other guys on E-Cubed have kind of developed for this particular method. So I will try to show them off. I believe that will work. So what we want to do is get like a little step. Can I jump up there? Yes, I can. And then, oh wait, this may not work. Well, let's see if this works. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some of these rocks and I'm going to turn them into cobble. And let's see if they actually stay put. Yeah, it looks like they're staying put for now. So let's put a log in the corner. There we go. Log, and I believe that is it for the high and dry. I would like to demonstrate its usage. Poof. All right. So I'm going to wait until night, and I'll show you how this thing works. So let me get some food. I'll see you guys in a little bit. Okay, before night shows up, I wanted to show you guys the finished pit kiln. So I've got two ceramic vessels that I can put stuff in. Let's go ahead and do that. Dirt, gravel, some sticks. Hold on to that. And we'll fill up the other one. Clay, Bone, there we go. Just to clear up our inventory a little bit. Now this is the most important part that I wanted to show you guys. As soon as you can, get some of these jugs. They're really important and they'll help your survivability in the long run. And you'll probably be using them throughout the rest of the game. So now you can fill them up with fresh water and drink out of it. So you don't have to keep running back to the stream every time. And did I use up? Yeah, I did. I used up all my rocks in making cobble. So the next thing I want to do before the end of this is show you guys how to at least plant some crops and get on to some more surviving. So let's go ahead and make a hoe. A stone hoe is really all you need at this point. So the shape looks like that. And I'm going to go ahead and make two of those just in case. And what did I do with my sticks? Oh, I put them down here. Grab my sticks. Finish that up. One, two. Okay. So, I don't know what's up, whether it's a glitch in Terra Firmacraft or some other mods that may be conflicting. But occasionally some of the grass doesn't want to till. So for now, I'm just going to till up a bunch of this. And we'll put our garlic over here. And stick the rice over here. So it looks like the next day is coming. So let me go ahead and show you guys how the high and dry method works. Let me run over to my rock. And as you can see from here, none of the sides are less than too high from all directions. And that's the point, is that when zombies come up here and try to attack you, they won't be able to climb up this at all. Spiders still will be able to get up this, but zombies will not. So it's a pretty good defense. Let me go ahead and make up a couple more javelins. Like this. And do we see any enemies? I do not. Oh, and this thing right here. This is important because you can climb up it and then jump up here. It gives you access to the platform, but the zombies can't get up it. So as you'll see, we've got our first contestant. Hey, buddy, how's it going? You want to try and catch the spear? Yeah? All right, let's try that. Catch the spear. Aha. And I think I used that up, so we'll try another one. Got him. See, he's trying to get up there, but he can't just can't quite make it. Come on. Now, you do want to be careful. Some of the enemies in Terra Firmapunk do have a jump boost effect on them, so they may be able to actually get up here, but 90% of them will not. Now, the skeleton, again, is going to be a problem. I'm not going to be able to take the skeleton by myself in my currently wounded state, so I really want to avoid him, especially the other one. I might actually want to go for a swim. But that is, I believe, the end of my demonstration on surviving the first night. And we'll say goodbye to this skeleton. We'll see you later. Well, look at that. We've got a bunch of friends. Where are you? There is one of the added monsters. Here he is. He is zipping all over the place. But he's one of the guys I added from Twilight Forest out. They're gonna kick my butt. I'm not gonna make it to daylight. But, yeah. Okay. So thanks for watching. We'll see you later. Bye-bye.